Hey, my name is Tiff. In my past, I was a line cook for about 10 years.
Hi, my name is Matt. I was a chef for 10 years.
I'm Mike. I was a chef for probably 16 years. And this is my dream knife kit.
This is a crumpler bag. I have always been an outdoor enthusiast, and so I love the like nylon vibe of this bag. What they have done is a lot of awesome stuff inside this bag. Sorry about the... There are a lot of extra touches in here that are super awesome that I really appreciate. Little pockets that are great for band-aids. There's a lot of space for a lot of stuff in here. You can fit your little tools, you can fit a notebook, you can fit your band-aids, as I said, and you can fit 9 knives in there. Easy to clean, that's why I would pick this. First knife, Yuki Gyudo, 210. I know it's short, but I'm a short guy. I would pick this knife because I am a sucker for a good nishiji, and I think that the finish on this knife is perfection. Really great for just everyday use, chopping and slicing all your veggies, making sure that everything is in tip-top shape for lunch service. Next knife, I would choose the Tadafusa Hochokobo bread knife. As I said, I made a lot of sandwiches, particularly in the last job that I had. We were a lunch service restaurant and, you know, I would have killed for a decent bread knife. We used all kinds of different breads, some crusty, some soft, you know, some deep fried. We did all kinds of stuff. And so this knife is awesome because you can use it for pretty much anything. The teeth at the front will dig through a hard crust, and then the sharp blade at the back will just sort of guide it through the rest of the bread, which is awesome. Yeah, I love this knife. It's kind of a daily driver in my home, in my life. I would 10 out of 10 buy it for a friend. My next knife is the Nigara Hamono. This is a fancy, very fancy, very heavy Hanasuki. In one of my positions, I got, I don't know, 10 or 12 cases of chickens that I had to debone before lunch service every day. And so the faster I could get through that, the faster I could get to making sandwiches and soup, because we did a lot of chicken stuff, you know, chicken wings. We did thighs, we used them for soup. Chicken, super versatile bird, have them, they're great. But deboning a chicken is a real situation in a kitchen, and you want to be able to do it quickly and efficiently and have a good tool to do it. Why would I pick the fanciest Hanasuki that I could find? Because it's the fanciest. You know, sometimes when you're sitting in a kitchen and your whites are dirty and it's hot and you're sweaty and everything is gross, sometimes you just want to feel like a lady.
Man, I feel like a woman.
And so you need a turquoise handle. And so that's why I would choose the fancy one. It feels great in hand, it'll get the job done, and it'll make you feel like $1 million. My next knife that I would choose is the Masashi Kokuin 240 Tsujihiki. After lunch service was finished, we would often prep for evening, which was usually parties and catering, and usually there was a lot of canapes involved. Let me tell you that the first time I sliced a series of smoked salmons, I didn't do it with a good knife, and it didn't go really well, and I did get yelled at for wasting a lot of money. And so I would choose a really good slicing knife for lots of reasons. It's not particular for slicing salmon, but if you needed to work a carving station, if you needed just to feel good while carving up chicken breasts or something like that, then, you know, I would go Tsujihiki. I use one of these in my kitchen now all the time because I slice a lot of stuff. If you buy a roast and you want to cut it into steaks for some crazy reason, you can. It goes through really quickly. It makes fast and precise and smooth cuts, and it feels really great doing it. Masashi is one of my favorite blacksmiths for a lot of reasons, and the Kokuin is one of my favorite lines because I love the smoky blackness. I'm a sucker for a really good knife like this one. The last knife I would choose is the Kun Raikon serrated paring knife. This knife is awesome for a lot of reasons, and I don't really want to wax too poetic about it, but this is a great little workhorse of a knife. If you need to get through, you know, a pile of cherry tomatoes, or if you need to do I don't know, a whole evening's worth of florets or something like that, you need a good paring knife. And I like to use something like this because sometimes you need a knife that you're willing to sacrifice to the cooking gods. There are sometimes dirty deeds that need to be done. And, you know, if you can pick up a knife dirt cheap, you might as well. All right, it's accessories time. I have this selection of things that I like to use now. I didn't necessarily use them when I was cooking professionally, but if I had them, I would have for sure. This is a Knifewear pan scraper. Makes cleaning your pans a lot easier and faster. This is a fancy spoon that you can use for plating, tasting, eating. You can do all kinds of things with a spoon, but this one has a nice weight. I really like the finish and the color makes it unique, so no one's stealing my spoon. This one is a fancy slotted spoon made by Gestura that I love. This is great for getting things out of jars, letting them drain, out of pans, letting them drain. I made a lot of sandwiches while I was cooking for lunch service, and you know what? A slotted spoon is a magical thing to have on the line. Spoonula, just a regular old silicone spatula type spoonula thing. Super useful in a million and a half different ways. Maybe that's a video for the future. Does lots of stuff. And my last and favorite tool are the King tongs. These do everything, including help you pass the time.
So the knife bag I've chosen is this beautiful one from Crumpler. We just got them in. I think they're super cool. And they come with a set of Band-Aids, which is always my thing. And it's orange. It's great. Okay, so starting off, my favorite chef's knife is this one from Haddo. It's the Haddo Ginsan. It's a stainless steel kiritsuke, 210 millimeters, and I can do pretty much everything I want with it without needing to worry about it rusting. I think Haddo is super cool because like the craftsmanship that goes into every step is phenomenal, as well as like they've kept the look really clean. I think it looks beautiful. And when using it, this thing performs like you would not believe. So the next knife in my kit would be this. This is the Yukurosaki Gekko. Again, another really nice stainless steel petty knife. You might notice the trend with everything I've picked is stainless steel. Working in kitchens for a long time, there's a lot of times you just wouldn't have time to stop and clean things. So just being able to have a knife that's low maintenance but still performs really well is great. This also has a little bit of an offset nature, which gives you some knuckle clearance underneath. I find it really useful. You can work with it in your hands, you can work with it on a board, and it's a really beautiful, easy to look after knife. So the next knife I've got is a bread knife. This beautiful one from Tajiro, really easy to look after, does not break the bank. And honestly, when I've been using bread knives in previous jobs, you can do it for so many things. I've used a knife almost exactly like this for everything from slicing bread to portioning like big slabs of pork belly and everything in between. It's a great knife, it's comfortable, it's not fussy. That's why I like it. It'll do sourdoughs, it'll do brioche, it'll do whatever you put to it. All right, the next knife in my kit would be an Arco salmon knife. I worked in a lot of fish restaurants sort of in my past, and a lot of the times filleting and skinning a piece of fish is a big part of your morning prep. So having the right tool for the job is great. Now this one has got a lot of flex to it, so you can work really close to the board. It's got the length you need so you can do all sizes of fish, and it's even fluted along the sides, which means it's not gonna stick to the blade. Great for when you are trying to get that really clean slice without having any sort of tearing or pulling from the fish. The other reason I chose this one specifically is I'm left-handed. A lot of the traditional Japanese fish knives are single bevel and they tend to be biased towards a right-handed person. You can get left-handed Yanagibas, but just for the sake of something that's easy to come by and you're not gonna be waiting around trying to find a left-handed Yanagiba, an Arco salmon knife is a really great substitute. Again, the next knife in my dream kit is this from Ryusen. I love Ryusen knives. When I started working at Knifewear, the first knife I used was the Ryusen Blazen Nikiri, and it genuinely set the tone for how good Japanese knives can be in my mind. This one here is made of a powdered stainless steel. It stays sharp for a really long time. The look is really nice as well. And my favorite part of this knife is this tapered handle. It kind of swells out to fit the palm of your hand and then down again. So when you pinch this knife, it's super comfortable, which is great for if you are slicing a larger piece of meat, a big slice of protein, you can kind of just work very comfortably towards yourself or even sort of use it to slice a big stack of herbs. I have seen it done. but my next knife might also do that. So this is the most recent addition to my wish list. This is a Chinese cleaver from CCK, a really great company. This one here is what they call the vegetable chopper. It's a little thicker in the spine, it's stainless. It is a great knife for doing all those things that you want to do without having to worry about it. It's pretty durable. It will go through some small bones. And if you just want a knife that's gonna do all the work for you, this is a great choice to go. It's not too big, it's not too heavy, but if you want a knife that you don't need to baby and you can just kind of hammer home, because sometimes that's what you need to do, this is a great one for it. If I was working in kitchens for this, this would be awesome if you were about to make stocks to just separate some of those smaller bones, even to take it to the board and just crush some garlic. This is not gonna complain if you treat it a little rough, and it's still gonna cut things nicer than you would expect a cleaver to. So my first accessory I've got is this R. Murphy Duxbury Shucker. I worked in a restaurant with a cold bar. We used to do dozens of oysters at a time, and so having the right piece of gear for the job was perfect. This handle is kind of a non-slip. The point is sturdy. You can get into all types of oysters, and it will make short work of a quick stack. The next thing I kind of want to talk about is scissors. You use a pair of scissors more than you expect in a professional kitchen. Anything from taking the fins off a fish to just slicing parchment paper so that you're ready for service. These are a great inexpensive option for that. They also have a little nutcracker in there, a tin opener, and my favorite part about them is that they are separatable, which means you can clean them easily. It means you can sharpen them. Potentially more important than a pair of scissors, good peeler. I don't think it really needs explaining. This one is stainless steel. It's got a good weight in the hand and the blade on it's curved. So if you're peeling like a potato or a carrot, you're not wasting motion. You're peeling off a really efficient slice each time. I'm kind of an accessories minimalist. So when people start talking about tweezers, I usually go on the back foot and get defensive and say you don't need them. But I recently got a set of these King tongs and I've been surprised how much I use them. You can use them for anything from your turning proteins in a pan. So if you're outside grilling and you just need to correct a bit of charcoal, these things have the durability, the sturdiness to be able to accomplish that. They're comfortable in the hand and the size wise, they fit in a knife bag really nicely just along with the rest of your gear. The final two things are little bits, a offset spatula, turning things in a pan, scraping out the sides of a cake or a loaf pan. You can use this for pretty much anything. Most important thing, is a Sharpie. If your chef sees you've not labeled something cleanly, you will get in trouble. If you've not labeled it at all, you will get in trouble. Having something that is good makes a huge difference. As you can see, I'm actually wearing an apron and I have a Sharpie in my pocket. Can't break that habit.
There's many beautiful knife bags out there in the world. I really appreciate this knife bag for its utilitarianness. What you can do is easily tuck in and grab a knife. You can get a lot of knives in here and they tuck away pretty safely. There's hard sheets of plastic in between each layer, plus this little thing in between. Knife number one, Kumo 240 Gyuto. This knife for me is the knife that I would drive all day long. It's light, it's thin, it's stainless steel, which means I don't have to baby it. I can literally cut everything with this knife. This is the knife. This is the knife for everything, all the time. Everything is after this knife. Knife number two, small utility petty knife. I love this Kiritsuki from Nigara. A little knife like this can get kind of tossed around in a kitchen, having something a little bit tougher. I might just need this knife in the middle of the heat of the action, and I don't have time to stop and baby it or wipe it dry, or worry about keeping it from rusting. So that's why I choose stainless steel here. This is the kind of knife that you can use for a lot of purposes. It's actually a decent sized blade. You can make this little guy do a lot of work. This is the Fujimoto Kurochi Forge 270mm Tsujihiki. I'm not too worried about the carbon steel factor here, and that's because when I'm cutting meat, I'm gonna be very focused and very organized on the work I'm doing. This blue carbon will have a really beautiful toothy edge. It'll portion steaks or fish or chops really, really nicely. Nice long thin blade so I get a nice smooth slender cut. This will be a trusty steed for sure. This is a Honosuke specifically designed for butchering poultry. I distinctly remember one day working at Model Milk. I'd been visiting Kevin at Knifewear and he'd shown me one of these knives I got to work later that day and I had to break down a whole bunch of chickens. I put my stuff away, I grabbed my phone, I went out to the parking lot and I called him and said, "You still got that Honosuke?" And I still have that Honosuke, and I can tell you something, it's wicked for doing any work around a bird. It allows you to go around the curves of the bones really nicely. This is the Fujimoto Nishiji. It's got a carbon steel edge for wicked sharpness, and it's got a stainless steel layer on the outside, so it's not as much to manage. Boy, this is a really great knife, and to be honest, really good value as well. The 210mm Gyuto. This is a knife that a lot of people find themselves using, especially when we're working in smaller kitchens or you're working on a station. Sometimes those cutting stations are really small, so a knife longer than this is kind of hard to manage. And you get a lot of use out of this. This is a Takamura SG2. It's a powdered stainless steel. It's nothing fancy when you look at it, but there are any number of chefs in this city who have this knife and love it because it does the job and it does it well. This is a really, really awesome, dependable stalwart of a knife. This is the Masashi Kokuen 165 Santoku. This is a bit of bling. I like it. I like the size and shape of this knife too. If you're just standing there chopping a whole bunch of small things, maybe a knife like this is really great to have. It's really manageable. Sometimes you go and do offsite caterings. Sometimes you get to go on the breakfast TV show and you need something a little flash. Sometimes your cook forgets their knives on the bus. And you kind of got to help them out, or you need your dishwasher to cut up a case of onions for you. So sometimes you got to have a couple extras. So having a bit of a selection is helpful for that. I have a lot of respect for Masashi's tools. He's a super, super good blacksmith. I would be more than proud to rock one of his knives in a kitchen. Listen, you're gonna need a bread knife. Probably if you're working in a restaurant, it's gonna be crostini when you do some Christmas party. You're gonna have to slice a baguette. You're gonna have to probably slice a dozen baguettes. This thing has fine little teeth. This is the Tojiro Classic bread knife. It cuts through a baguette like it's like got a zipper on it. And this is a welcome addition to my toolkit. Okay, this is a little sleeper of a knife. This is the Sakai Takayuki SK4 series. SK4 is in fact the steel type. It is a little bit flexible. It's gonna be really, really easy to put an edge on this knife. And some days all you need is to make your knife sharp using your ceramic rod. You don't have time to hit sharpening stones. You just need your knife back. This is a beautiful little knife. It's very, very functional. I got a lot of time for these little guys too. So this size and shape I think is really useful. Now, this is a bit of a luxury. First of all, a Yanagiba is a single bevel knife. This is designed for slicing fish. Sometimes you get a big promotion. Sometimes you get a new job. Sometimes you deserve something special. A really ballin' Yanagiba, absolutely something special. I think this thing runs about $600, and to me, it's worth every penny. Just wait till you slice up a whole loin of tuna with this thing. Ain't nothing wrong with showing off now and again, right? Sometimes you need a big beast of a knife to do mean things to. Yeah, this thing is great. It is what it is. It's nothing fancy, but when you start cooking, you're not very likely to jump into whole carcass butchery right away. If you do, that's rad, and get yourself one of these cleavers then. But otherwise, when you need it, come and see us and we'll sort you out. Sometimes you need a knife in your pocket because you got to bust open the straps on a case and you don't want to use your kitchen knife. A really good fish scaler. You don't want to rip the fish apart with a cheap scaler. Combo stone, 1,000, 3,000. That's all you need. In a pinch, 1,000, 3,000 should refresh your edge if you're getting a little dull. Have a good notebook. You should buy this one, probably because I made it and I think it's awesome. The white honing rod is the honing rod if you're a professional. It will renew your knife quite nicely. Peelers, yeah, you can peel a potato with a paring knife, but why would you? This is so much better at that job. Oyster shucker, you know what? When you need one, you need one. Learn how to shuck properly. You're not scrambling eggs. A microplane's indispensable for making it snow parm cheese on your risotto. And a good plating spoon is crucial, as we all know. Even several or a few plating spoons can be nice. Now, if you want to actually see my knife kit and the one I built over several years and lots of travel, you can check out one of these videos here that we've done with my whole kit. Also, you should check out our man Nolan's videos too. He's a maniac. lid on my water bottle and I soaked my bag of nuts. That's the thing I did the first this morning.
I thought you soaked your nuts on purpose.
I didn't soak my nuts on purpose. I soaked my nuts on accident. Now I got a soaking wet nut bag.